Once upon a time, they came out from the deep, from the very far south. They were the very best in their trade. Therefore, they were the chosen ones, the only trusted squad, to protect the most precious of all, the throne of Egypt. They were called the Elite Warriors Legion, the Magi's. Today, Egypt has no pharaohs, no throne, no royalty, but a great civilization. Yet, she still has her elite platoon. They converted from a squad of warriors to a multitude of exceptionally talented troops, the Magi's of civilization, guardians of the spirit within.
There is but little room for doubt that Egypt led the way in the creation of the earliest known group of civilizations, which arose on both sides of the land bridge between Africa and Eurasia in the 4th millennium BC. James Henry Brissett.
Welcome to Planet Egypt, where all and everything really began. The deep roots of the Egyptian civilization go back more than 9 millennia to the beginning of settled life along the banks of the River Nile. The country has an unusual geographical and cultural unity that has given the Egyptian people a strong sense of identity and a pride in their heritage as descendants of humankind's earliest civilized community. While the Sumerians, Babylonians, Akkadians, and other groups were busy creating a Mesopotamian civilization in the fertile crescent of the ancient Near East, another civilization had already been established to their west. Archaeological evidence show, with no doubt, that organized society states existed on the Egyptian land over 6 millennia ago, in many centers as Beni Salema, Fayoum, Naqada, Abydos, El Kab, and Komombo. Again, this civilization depended entirely upon geography. It was the fertile valley of the Nile River that allowed Egyptian civilization to flourish over the course of many centuries. It is an area of the world in which much needed natural resources were abundant. Furthermore, the climate of Egypt is very dry and almost changeless. Because of this static, changeless quality, the Egyptians obtained a sense of security from their environment. The basic element in the lengthy history of Egyptian civilization is geography. The Nile River originates from the lakes of Central Africa as the White Nile and from the mountains of Ethiopia as the Blue Nile. The White and Blue Nile meet at Khartoum and flow together northward to the Nile Delta, where the 4,000-mile course of this river spills into the Mediterranean Sea. For centuries, ancient Egyptian civilization flourished in isolation from the rest of the ancient Near East. Yet, although Egypt was isolated, it was not originally unified. The small Egyptian states were regrouped at around 5000 BC into two large kingdoms, one being the Kingdom of the Delta, and the other the Kingdom of the Upper Valley of the Nile. The years 4500 BC to 3300 BC are called the Magdalene, which corresponds to the three ages of the pre-dynastic period of Egypt: ancient, middle, and recent. During the 4th millennium BC, the kingdom of the south took over the north, and the pre-dynastic pharaohs reigned over a united Egypt. According to the Stone of Palermo, scientists have counted at least 25 kings who already had ruled in the two kingdoms of Upper and Lower Egypt. There were 10 kings who had already ruled over a united Egypt, and there were as many predecessors to them. They wore the two crowns of royalty, the White Crown of Upper and Middle Egypt and the Red Crown of Lower Egypt. The two crowns united constitute the Peshment, the crown of unified Egypt. This happened long before the advent of the first official royal dynasty. Power was centralized in the hands of a god king, and thus Egypt became the first organized society. The tomb paintings in Hierakonpolis, those on the Nile of Jebel el Araq, and similar artifacts show pictures of boats without sails or oars, some of lions, of dogs, and especially of wars between two people of identical appearance, except for their styles of hairdressing. Geographically, Egypt was divided between the Black Land and the Red Land, and politically between Upper and Lower Kingdoms. The recent pre-dynastic Egyptians considered the unification of Upper and Lower Egypt as the most important event in their history. Within the long sweep of Egyptian history, certain events and epochs have been crucial to the development of the Egyptian society and culture. One of these was what is believed to be the second unification of Upper and Lower Egypt, sometime in the 4th millennium BC. The ancient Egyptians regarded this event as the most important in their history, comparable to the first time what they thought as the creation of the universe. With the unification of the two lands by the legendary King Narmer, the glorious pharaonic age began. Religion was integral to Egyptian life. Religious beliefs formed the basis of Egyptian art, medicine, astronomy, literature, and government. The Great Pyramids were burial tombs for the pharaohs who were revered as gods on earth. magical utterances pervaded medical practices since disease was attributed to the gods. Astronomy evolved to determine the correct time to perform religious rites and sacrifices. The earliest examples of literature dealt almost entirely with religious themes. The pharaoh was a sacrosanct monarch who served as the intermediary between the gods and man. Justice, too, was conceived in religious terms, something bestowed upon man by the creator god. Finally, the Egyptians developed an ethical code which they believed the gods had approved. The Egyptians believed not only in body and soul, but in Ka, the indestructible vital principle of each person, which left the body at death, but which could also return at other times. This explains why the Egyptians mummified the dead, so that the Ka, on its return, would find the body not decomposed. And this also explains why tombs were filled with wine, grain, weapons, sailing ships, and so on. Ka would find everything it needed, otherwise it might come back to haunt the living. The ancient Egyptian was ready to accept any and all gods and goddesses that seemed appropriate. For instance, if a new area was incorporated into the Egyptian state, its gods and goddesses would be added to the pantheon of those already worshipped. Despite the ever-increasing number of deities, which could be added to the hierarchy of deities, one thing is certain: Egyptian religion, unlike the religion of Mesopotamia, was centralized. Indeed, it was often difficult to know where one aspect began and another ended. By contrast, the function of an Egyptian temple was focused on religion. We are certain that ancient Egyptians were preoccupied with life after death. They believed that after death, each human being would appear before Osiris and recount all the evil that had been committed during one's earthly existence.
I have not done evil to men. I have not ill-treated animals.
And so on. This was a negative confession and justification for admittance into the blessed afterlife. Osiris would then have the heart of a person weighed in order to determine the truth of their confession. Egyptian religion, unlike that of Mesopotamia, was monotheistic, since each region had its own patron deity. Some of these local or regional gods gained notoriety throughout Egypt. For instance, the god Ptah gained power when the city of Memphis became the capital of Egypt. Later, the god Ra of Heliopolis eclipsed that of Ptah. Finally, the god Amun rose to supremacy in Thebes in connection with political authority of the Theban pharaoh. As a ruler, whenever a new capital was founded, a new supreme god was chosen. Egyptian gods were often represented as animals, as falcons, vultures, a cobra, dog, cat, or crocodile. For the Egyptians, because animals were non-human, they must have possessed religious significance. Other gods such as Ptah and Amun were given human representation. But the most important god, Ra, was not represented at all. The gods created the cosmos. They created order out of chaos. Egyptian religion inspired confidence and optimism in the external order and stability of the world. The gods guided the rhythms of life and death, and what really distinguished Egyptian religion from that of Mesopotamia was that any man or woman could share in the benefits of the afterlife. Once again, unlike the Sumerians, the life of the Sumerian was filled with anxiety and pessimism because the gods themselves were unstable and the idea of an afterlife was unknown. As one historian has put it, death meant a continuation of one's life on Earth, a continuation that, with the appropriate precautions of proper burial, prayer, and ritual, would include only the best parts of life on Earth. Nothing to fear, but on the other hand, nothing to want to hurry out of this world for. Thus, religion was the unifying agent in ancient Egypt. Pharaoh indicated his concern for his people by worshipping the local deities in public ceremonies. The gods protected the living and guaranteed them an afterlife. The Egyptians believed they were living in a fixed, static, or unchanging universe in which life and death were part of a continuous, rhythmic cycle. Certain patterns came to be expected. Grain had to be harvested, irrigation canals had to be built, and pyramids had to be built. Just as the sun rose in the east and set in the west, so too all human life and death passed through regular and predictable patterns. The ancient Egyptians were the first people of antiquity to believe in life after death. They were the first to build in stone and to fashion the ark in stone and brick. Even before the unification of the two lands, the Egyptians had developed a plough and a system of writing. They were accomplished sailors and shipbuilders. They learned to chart the heavens in order to predict the Nile flood. Their physicians prescribed healing remedies and performed surgical operations. They sculpted in stone and decorated the walls of their tombs with naturalistic murals in vibrant colors. The legacy of ancient Egypt is written in stone across the face of the country, from the pyramids of Upper Egypt to the rock tombs in the Valley of the Kings, to the Old Kingdom temples of Luxor and Karnak, to the Ptolemaic temples of Edfu and Dendera, and to the Roman temple to Isis on Fela Island. This is, in brief, the story we are about to tell. The story of Egypt, its identity, character, and uniqueness. So welcome to Planet Egypt, where all and everything really began.